And to this day, our people across this land fight to carry on this war of resistance. So our next big day, our next big treaty day, will be the 26th of January. And that again will be a big rally, a big march, and again we will honour those traditions of resistance. Because we didn't welcome the British into our country. We didn't sit down with the British and sign a contract, sign a treaty.
They'll come in wagons, three and four loads of them, and they'll move the old people out. They've got no other life. Are they thinking about that? This is their land.
And then after that, we have to go down to the riverbank and sleep on the riverbank down there with no blankets, nothing. The coppers kick us out of here. We got a big fire going. Get out. Yeah, then we have to walk from here and go down to the riverbank and sleep down there, no blankets, nothing, and shiver. Shiva, this must be our land.
I'd like to just thank everybody here today for coming, showing the support and that there. For this, today's rally, and respect for this old fella Dundalee. My name is Morris Mickelo. Stolen generation of our people's history will never be forgotten. Now, so much devastation and corruption by this Australian government rule and the standover tactics, manipulation, intimidation on our people. How it affects us and our younger generation of way of life. Yous have stolen our Aboriginal identity. Yous are breaking our spirits. Our children locked up in youth detention centres being bashed by correctional officers of the State Department and being refused to be back into their family's care. This devastation and brutality has got to stop. All Aboriginal people on this earth, this land, we have suffered significantly. We have put up with so much Australian government laws, its manipulation, its heinous crimes. On our people. I'm only 30 years old. I was tasered and shot twice by the Queensland police, handcuffed to a bed in hospital, fighting for my life. While these Queensland police were sitting at the end of my bed, manipulating me, intimidating me more and more after I just finished fighting for my life. My son is 11 years old. He was incarcerated in Brisbane Youth Detention Centre. Three male officers brutally assaulted my child, fractured my child's jaw, gave him two black eyes, broke his hand, and sent him up to Ipswich Hospital in handcuffs. How does that make me feel? 2 days before Christmas, how does that make me and his family feel? Tonight, 2 days before Christmas, my son, their child, is getting bashed by these officers. And this State Department and its wrongdoings, they need to be accounted for, they need to be investigated. The family being denied information of what's happened to this child, medical reports, when's the next time he's going to go to hospital? My son has to have an operation on his face because of what this government and this police have done to my child. It sickens me to my guts what this government can do and so-called get away with it. They get away with so much murder, so much corruption, police brutality on our people. Enough is enough. We need justice in our communities. We need justice for our people. The Australian government, under the British law, the Commonwealth Crown, that served this country with its Australian government laws, where they breached their own protocols, they breached their own acts of discipline and whatever. That's you white fellas' way of life. Us Aboriginals, we've been here for over 200 years on this earth, on this land, and we're still suffering. Our kids are still suffering. Like my uncle said the other day at the other rally, if the white men can't look after our kids, give them back to us. We'll take them, we'll go look after them. We'll put all the spirit and culture back into their lives. It's still there, we still got it. We're still a generation, we haven't been forgotten, we were never lost. We're here today in remembrance of this old fella Dundalee. And standing here today, justice for my child and for all other Aboriginal children that have been criminal brutality, assaults and stuff put on them from this government, this department and its laws. Whether the Prime Minister of Queensland or Queensland Premier come to the table and say enough is enough and serve justice for the children of this land, the Aboriginal people. My uncle, Danny Mickelo, he was a warrior of his people. He was falsely accused for a crime he didn't commit and to serve a life sentence in prison. Have so much corruption, law put upon him, being denied a chance at freedom, a chance at a new life. My uncle come out in a wooden box. Me, his nephew, being tasered and shot twice. Fighting for my life. I'm still here today, standing here amongst us all. I'm fighting for my own life with this government and its wrongdoings to me. And I'm fighting for my son and its wrongdoings, what it's done to my son. I'm an Aboriginal man. The tribe of my people is Jawa. We originate west of Toowoomba, the Darling Downs region. Too many things in the state, Queensland government go untold, and the government turns its blind eye on it. Enough is enough. How many more kids have to be bashed? How many more kids have to die? How many more kids have to be suffered? And the women, young girls being molested and fucking raped and everything else because of these so-called state police? They have a history themselves, and their history is convicts. They come from a long, long boat slavery. They know what they've done wrong and what they've done wrong to this land. Us Aboriginal people, we're not stupid. We never was. How we can stand here and this government play us like fools on our own land, our own country, and get away with these acts and these crimes? I don't know. There's so much more that I want to say, but I'm going to hold my pride and I'm going to let my other elders do the talking. I've said what I had to say. Enough is enough.
Okay.